in America, top three selling vehicles in America are pickup trucks. We have to, if to solve sustainable energy, we have to have a pickup truck. So I present to you the Cybertruck. Doesn't look like anything else. So we'll start off with the size, the dimensions, and the inspiration. So the functionality I'm going to describe is within a space that is less than the most popular pickup truck in the United States, the F-150. So we didn't cheat in either width, height, or length. And we're able to achieve much greater capability in the same dimensions, same weight. Yeah. The part of this is the fundamental design change. We moved the mass to the outside. We created an exoskeleton. So normally, the way that a truck is designed, you have a body on frame, you have a bed on frame, and the body and the bed don't do anything useful. They're carried like cargo, like a sack of potatoes. It was the way that aircraft used to be designed, when they had biplanes, basically. The key to creating an effective monoplane was a stressed skin design. You move the stress to the outside skin. Allows you to do things that you can't do with a body on frame. So we're able to make the skin out of thick, ultra hard stainless steel. It's really hard. We're going to show you just how hard. So Franz has a sledgehammer. Yeah, don't hold back. Okay. Yeah. It's a regular truck door.
Want me to do this?
Go, do it. Yeah. Yeah, hit it a couple times.
You want to hit it again? All right.
Yeah. Yeah, nice. Now hit the Cybertruck. Same thing. Hit it harder. Wind up, nail it.
Yeah.
It's pretty strong.
Very strong. So if you think about like a truck, you want a truck that's tough. You want a truck that's really tough, not fake tough. You want a truck that can take a sledgehammer too. A truck that won't scratch, doesn't dent. What else can we do with this truck? What if we shot it? Let's shoot it. Guy, OSHA. I mean, come on. So that's a 9mm bullet shot at the door.
Shoot it.
We're in California, unfortunately. But the 9mm, it is literally bulletproof to a 9mm handgun. That's how strong the skin is. So it's ultra hard, cold rolled, stainless steel alloy that we've developed. We're going to be using the same alloy in the Starship rocket and in the Cybertruck. Yeah, you're welcome. So on the right, that's like normal truck doors. Like, you might as well be made of tissue paper. That looks like a paintball. Very different. So, you know, when you say something's built tough, that's what we mean. What about the glass? Seems like a vulnerability. Yeah. Transparent metal glass. Yeah, that's right. Let's show some of the tests. What can we do with this? All right. Let's show the glass demo. There you go. So first, this is regular glass. This is like normal glass, car glass. I want to show you what happens with normal car glass. Shatters immediately with a little ball. Now I'll show you Tesla armor glass. Nothing. Yeah. But it's kind of a small ball though. It's maybe like do it at a bigger height with a yeah. So still there. I guess. Yeah, not bad. A bigger ball. Yeah. Yeah. Franz, could you try to break this glass, please? Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah. Oh my fucking God. Well, maybe that was a little too hard.
Should we try it on
the board? Sorry? Yeah. It didn't go through. That's a plus side.
Let's try the right.
Try that one, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, man.
It didn't go through. All right. Yeah, not bad. A little room for improvement. All right, let's see. So, yeah.
Shoot it!
We'd actually throw everything. We threw wrenches. We threw everything. We even literally threw the kitchen sink at the glass, and it didn't break. For some weird reason, it broke now. I don't know why. You know, just fix it in post. So, in addition, the car has an adaptive air suspension. It's literally built, with adaptive air suspension. So, this will come standard on all the cars. I think this is actually a very important design element, because if you have every truck has the ability to adjust the ride height, so you can go very low or very high, so you can be efficient on the highway, and you can also go off-roading. It's going to have the highest clearance of any production truck, so we're going to have about a 16-inch clearance. You can adjust this on the fly. So it's adaptive damping and adaptive ride height. These are actually extremely important for a truck. Because trucks, when you only drive them, they're either too cushy or they're too hard. You need it to be able to adjust dynamically depending upon what the load is. If you've got a lot of people on board, if you've got a full bed in the back, it's got to adjust accordingly. So, yeah. Let's talk about the, we call it the Vault, Cybertruck Vault. So, let's see. Let's demo this active. So the rear is 100 cubic feet, 6.5 foot length, bed length, up to 3,500 pounds of payload. And it can tow. But what about a real world test? Like let's actually have a tug of war here with an F-150. So you can see, see which one can pull which. Let's do the tug of war video. Pull. But it was uphill. So let's see, on road, the performance. Wow. Now let's see how does this compare to a Porsche 911? Okay, we're going to give the Porsche a little bit of a head start. Yeah, this is a current edition Porsche. This is the actual truck. This is not CGI. In terms of off-road performance, it's going to have the best approach angle, best clearance heights, best departure angle. For people that are really going off-road, this is going to be great. You could basically do the Baja Rally in this thing. We have three ranges. So obviously it'll have access to all the superchargers, be capable of more than 250 kilowatts. We'll reveal the actual number later. It has onboard outlets for 110 and 220 volts. So you don't need a generator. Yeah. The truck literally is your generator. And as a little plus, because it's got an air suspension, we can tap off the air suspension so you have a pneumatic source. So you have an onboard air compressor. Of course, it will come with autopilot standard. Yep. So there'll be three versions. And but it's gonna. That's the price without any incentives. That's just like the price without any incentives. But the actual economics are even better than that, because the cost of electricity is much less than the cost of gasoline. So when you look at the actual cost of ownership here, it's you know, you're paying much less for electricity than you are for gasoline. You're paying much less for maintenance. There's no oil changes, no smog checks, no nothing, none of that stuff. So your maintenance is low, your cost of operations is low, and so it's actually comparable to a truck, a gasoline truck that's $10,000 to $15,000 less. Yeah. So. All right. Yeah. So you can order now if you would like. Tesla.com/Cybertruck. Oh, I should say also, we're going to be offering rides in this all night. Yeah, don't mind the glass. So, anyway, thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
I think it's going to be a great, great party, and you'll love riding around this thing. It's great. All right, thank you. Oh, wait. We have, should we do the, we also made an ATV, so. Well, let's bring it out. See the truck? This is what I mean by the adaptive air suspension. Yeah, nice work, by the way. So the adaptive air suspension, you can drop real low and you go high on the other side. We call this load mode. So you got a load mode, you got a built-in ramp. So you can take a ATV or dirt bike, whatever you want, and load it on the back. Yes. Oh. And it's currently plugged in and charging. Yeah. So look at the car is adjusting itself. So you can go like real tight on the freeway, and you can go way high off-roading. Yeah. All right. Thank you.